think it's probably coming up to about a year now that I've been coming to the recovery college. Yeah. It's called emotionally unstable personality disorder. It means is you're a little bit more sensitive with your emotions, and when certain emotions come out from certain situations, they're a little bit harder to understand than what somebody without the condition would be able to familiarise with emotions and know what to do and know what the feelings mean inside and how to react to certain situations. I feel like I have to have routines, so I have to have things in my head how things are going to be. So if something changes and a different emotion that I wasn't expecting comes to me, then I don't really know how to act, and it kind of throws me and it gets me a little bit confused. It can get you upset. Also, it can overcompensate as well, where you rely on others too much, but at the same time you feel like you're a burden, and you preempt things, what you think other people will think about you, when necessarily you don't actually know what they're thinking at all. Now I've got the diagnosis, thanks to Mersey, because coming to the recovery college, I was going on a couple of courses, and when they were discussing things, I couldn't relate as much as I wanted to or others were. So I got the diagnosis from coming to the recovery college. So now I'm on the waiting list to go and get some talk and therapy treatment. I'm on the right kind of medication now as well. I can get the support that I need, and now I'm learning how to react with my emotions and how to understand what they mean. So I feel like I'm on and up now. I feel like I've found out what the problem is and where I need to go, so I'm happy. At the recovery college, I go to something called Journeys Through Film, which is every 1 month we meet, in fact, in Liverpool City Centre, and we pick a film that we want to watch that highlights mental health, maybe the stigma, how people understand it, how it affects everybody's day-to-day life, who suffers from it, and those that are surrounded by it. So we go and we watch the film, and then after it we all group together and then we discuss how we perceive the film, can we relate to certain things in the film, and then at the end we vote, and then we vote on what we're going to watch the next time. It's helped me massively because, as I say, it's given me the confidence to go and ask for the help I need. It's given me the confidence to go and speak to family and friends and tell them that I'm suffering with mental health. And this is what I need from them, and this is how they can help me. It also helped me be able to get back into work, because I was off work for a long period of time. It helped me get back into my full-time job now as well. So it's just given me so much confidence to not be ashamed of suffering with a mental health. I'd say there's something for everybody in there. You get a brochure with all the different courses in, and you can just pick what ones you want to go to, and there's just a wide variety of courses. So I'd say just take the time to look at what's in the brochure, and there will be something there, and don't be afraid to go to the sessions, because once you're there, you're among people who are sharing your story, so you don't have to feel ashamed or embarrassed or scared. You're all together, so I'd definitely promote it, yeah. I'm feeling good. I feel like I know where I'm going now. I know where to move forward. I know I've got the support that I need, especially, it's just a brilliant service. It's there. I just feel like the staff that are involved in it are just, it's not like staff and service users. It's like you get to know them and they join in the sessions with you, and you get to build a good relationship up with them. And I feel like I'm always telling people about the recovery college. It's definitely a good thing, and I hope it's around for a while, to be honest.